So welcome to our channel. We are going to talk today on irritable bowel disorder or irritable bowel syndrome, or commonly known as IBS. So welcome, my name is Dr. Deepak Kelkar. I'm psychiatrist, sexologist, de-addiction specialist and hypnotherapist practicing at Akola, Maharashtra, India. So today I'm going to talk about irritable bowel disorder. About 10% of population, they are affected with this problem or with this disease, and is the third common illness amongst gastrointestinal disorder. The first one being gastric infection, the second is gastroesophageal reflux disease, and this is the third one, irritable bowel syndrome or irritable bowel disorder. Now this disease affects the quality of life and time off work. You know, people waste so much of time because of the illness. They don't go to their workplace, they are at home, not doing nothing, and that hampers quality of life also. Now, what are the criteria? How to diagnose? There is a recurrent abdominal pain with discomfort. So, if this is happening along with two out of the following three criteria, then we can say it's an irritable bowel disorder. So, which are those three criteria? Number one is there is improvement with defecation. Once he passes the stool or she feels better. Number two is onset of the disorder is associated with change in frequency of stool. And number three is onset associated with change in the form of stool. So out of these three, two criteria are met. And for 3 days in a month, in last 3 months consecutively. So 3 days in a month, in last 3 months, the onset should be from last 6 months, and two out of three criteria, if they are fulfilled, then we can say this is irritable bowel disorder or syndrome. Now, apart from recurrent abdominal pain and discomfort, there are many symptoms which are associated with this disease, and the person is suffering from those symptoms. So what are those symptoms? He gets belching, then eructations, maybe having hiccups, then there is constant regurgitation in the, as if, you know, the acid is coming into the chest, you know, coming to the throat or coming to mouth. Then there is a lot of pain in the abdomen, and there is a burning pain in the abdomen. A lot of discomfort in the abdomen. There is a gaseous discomfort. Then there is a gaseous distension. He passes gases either through mouth or through the anus. And then he has got discomfort, very much discomfort. He feels as if there is a lot of weight which is put on the abdomen. And he might be, you know, like passing lot many stools in a day, like frequency is a lot, or he is not passing at all. There is a constipation. Or even if he passes 2-3 times, there is a loose stool, you know, like watery stool. And he doesn't feel comfortable, you know, even after passing stool, he feels like again and again going to the, like to pass stools, and he is not comfortable. Now, this person has visited lot many doctors before coming to a psychiatrist. And doctors, they investigate like MRI, then sonography, USG of the abdomen, then X-rays are done, then lot many blood investigations are done, then endoscopies like gastroscopy, colonoscopy, now lot many scopies have been done, and all the reports, they are normal. At the most, when gastroenterologists, they see the patient, they say H. pylori infection. And so they give treatment for H. pylori infection. So that is all it is found. Otherwise, even after taking the tablets for the H. pylori infection, he is not feeling well. And then he is visiting so many doctors. And ultimately, he comes to psychiatrists. So when any person comes to me, you know, he like must have visited a lot many physicians or gastroenterologists, and he's coming with a lot many files. And then when I go through the files, all investigations are normal. And the consulting doctor or the physician, he says, no, you don't have any problem. You know, and then he prescribes some tonic or some anti-anxiety drug. And then he says, go and take rest, or nothing has happened, and you go home and take rest. Usually people are not working because of the problem. They are sitting at home, not doing anything. And they are visiting doctors. So this is the state of affairs. Now how to treat? Now there are medicines for treatment of this irritable bowel disorder, and with these medicines we can treat, like medicines, and then we have got psychotherapy, we have got hypnotherapy like hypnosis and hypnotherapy, then I do counseling. So with the medicines, with antacids, and with like treating H. pylori infection if it is there, or then counseling, psychotherapy, hypnotherapy, the person becomes all right. He may take 2-3 months or 4 months to become all right, and then he can enjoy his normal life. Like if you feel like 10% of people of the population is suffering from this, so please circulate this video, please share this video. People can contact me or my medical officers, they can guide them. I can do online counseling also, online counseling or online coaching or online consultation I do on, and consult person and advise him accordingly to what to do about the illness, or he can contact his psychiatrist at his own place. So there are numbers which are given, mobile numbers which are given, people can contact us, and anybody from our hospital, they can treat. I am myself also available for treating this particular illness. So if you like this video, please share. We have got 2 hospitals here where the person with irritable bowel disorder, he comes over here, we admit him for some days, for a week or so, and then we treat him, we give all sorts of treatment and becomes all right. So 30-40% cure is seen within 7 days, and then we prescribe medicines, and then he goes home and take the medicines at home. So if you feel please share this video, it will make a lot of difference, and please like and share also. Thank you very much.